Let's go through one level first and see how similar the template is to the first Kingdom Hearts game. If it truly is like a bunch of different siloed Disney worlds, and that's it. That's the entire game. Dude, Donald the Thug! Damn, nice facial expressions, animations. For sure, for sure. Like they're actually looking at the thing that they're looking at. Represents the party morale. It is game over when the gauge is empty. The gauge can be restored by orbs. The party morale? I have to deal with confidence and shit? Oh, you little bitch. Little bitch! Yeah! Who owns you now? Probably because I've seen this story of Fa Mulan. Like some variation of the story so many times that the actual specifics of this story, this specific story, kind of got lost on me. Just give us an assignment. Yeah, man, give me some more Heartless to kill, dammit. I need some more grinding. I got a map of the encampment area. Cool. Am I... Ooh, got missions? Oh, wait, I have to do different missions. So I can't just go off on my own. There's an actual specific mission to do. Run out. It goes down automatically? Like, I do nothing and it goes down. So far, this game has been abundant with mini-games of some kind. Well, he's static because I think the reason why he's static is because the formula, the Disney formula for these games is quite static. I'm about to lose all my morale. Oh god, oh Shenko! It's Shenko! You're the wrong game, girl. I need that, please, 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 give me that, give me that, give me that, give me that, give me me, give me me! Yes, in terms of the gameplay, I'll take that. Let's not make the same mistake as before. Absolutely consume that. But yeah, it seems like they're recycling the same formula from the first Kingdom Hearts game. The first section, like, the section where you're playing on the island before you get sucked into the Kingdom Hearts worlds in the first game is mirrored here in the portion of the game where you fight as Roxas. Then once that disappears, now we're going back to Sora. But then the template is now going back to the first Kingdom Hearts game as a bunch of siloed Disney worlds that you have to defeat, and all of them are completely unrelated to the others. I need my drive, I need my drive, I need my drive, I need my drive! I'll take that, thank you. What the? Context, context, context? Oh, shoot. I'll take that. No, no drive, no drive, no drive, no drive! Just chill! Just chill! Okay, okay, items, items, where is it? No! I can't access it. Okay, okay, okay. Ow, man! I gotta deal with morale at the same time, too. Dude, man. No, no context, no context. No reversal. There we go. What? I gotta deal with morale too? Dude. No, I need more, Sora, you suck, man. What happened to your reversal? Here's the problem. The problem is that I don't have like a dodge. I don't know if the block really helps. And also on top of that, I have to deal with morale. I need Goofy. I do be needing Goofy. Yeah, he's gonna make a big difference. Donald's like, eh, okay, okay, okay. The Valor Form gives me a bunch of different abilities, including the Gap Closer. That can be really, really helpful. All right, let's try this again. Let's try this again. Shenko be Cohen. Uh-huh, gotcha. Uh-huh, okay, okay, uh-huh, okay. Now I gotta deal with this bullshit. Fuck you, mother... What the hell? What the? Oh, nice, nice, nice. Morale though, morale, 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 morale. I need the ability to dodge out of the way. That's why reversal was so good, because I can basically not just dodge, but like sweep 100 degrees around. Well, that's not a big deal, like reading the enemies and then like not getting greedy and with hits. The only problem though is that I have to deal with morale. Because if the morale gauge goes down, I'm dead. So I have to constantly be hitting the enemies, which kind of sucks. Yeah, your block sucks, Sora. Your block freaking sucks. There really should be an ability to allow you to extend the duration of your block. Okay, I got 14, level 14. Nice, nice, nice. So, just like with the first game, when you execute a spell or use an item, you don't use it immediately. there's a delay in the time that you input the command versus actually using it. Oh. No, morale cage mother. I freaking hate that. Oh, no. Oh, this is bullshit. Yeah, there we go. What's up now, baby? Nice. Another one. Do you have like an opening at all? Like at all? So you're not fighting humans. You're just fighting like heartless versions of this world. Okay, so we reestablished a base all the way up in the mountains. So let's find out where Shen Yu is by ourselves. Then if we're lucky, we can fry him up good. Shen Yu is in a cave outside the village. And in the first Kingdom Hearts game, I suppose that's what made Sora feel like such a weak character. Because at the start, I thought, okay, we lost our friends, we lost Riku and Kairi, so we're gonna get them back. Sure, we did that, but because the game prioritized so much of the siloed Disney worlds, like we have to advertise, we're using this game as an advertisement for all of the Disney movies that came out between from the time of the previous game until this game, then Sora was just a bystander. He was a third-party bystander that just, he just goes along with the flow. He's adventuring, he's exploring, but what about the thing with Kairi and Riku? That takes a backseat. This game is very much about branding. Absolutely true. This is very much about branding. And the branding comes first and foremost above everything else. The Disney brand. Not the Square Enix brand, but the Disney brand. I think that Nomura took the plunge in Kingdom Hearts 3. I mean, children died in the Keyblade Wars? There's a Keyblade Wars? Oh, God. There's nobody here. I mean, I could buy the Elf Wars in Mega Man. I could buy the Machine Wars in Nier Automata, but the Keyblade Wars? What, a bunch of robe dudes acting as generals? Firing beams from very high places while crossing their arms? Edgelords. Where you going? Goofy, I need you. Oh, you mother... Damn it, morale. Okay, no morale. Awesome. Okay. Piece of shit. There we go. No. I'm pushing jump. Dude. The animation stun lock is brutal. Oh. No more MP. Okay, now I have to cheese these dudes. Cheese it. Okay, just cheese it. Just run around for about like a minute. Oh no. It's like I need Goofy to use the Valor Form. Why? Why not just give me use of the Valor Form the moment I have Limit Gauge 3? Nice. Slide Dash. Oh shoot. Gap Closer. I think. You can actually jump into the second game like I'm playing right now without even playing the first game. Really. I don't think it's even necessary to play the first game. Maybe you might get a little bit more context, but not much. I mean, look, the only context you really got from the first game was, okay, Sora, Riku, and Kairi are these characters who grew up on an island and they were friends from the beginning. And then some context about the Heartless and how they came to be. But all the stuff with Disney didn't matter. Because all the Disney stuff, the context, you can get that from the movies. Hyper healing. Oh shit, I need that. You don't have any items anyways. Quickly revives a fallen party member and greatly restores their at no cost to yourself. I'll take it. Characters also died in the mobile Kingdom Hearts Dark Roads. I mean, a child did kill another child with a keyblade, but not really kill, like kill quote unquote, right? They disappear into a beam of light kind of thing. We're not talking about blood. We're talking about sparkles, stars, rainbows, and shamrocks type of death. So far, Kingdom Hearts 2 has been a way more guided experience too. Like a lot of cutscenes, like almost a cutscene. One cutscene every two screens. The dialogue is quite simple and straightforward here, which I really appreciate. Not like huge exposition dumping. Exposition dumping is usually the result of conflicts that are not very interesting, but they feel like they need you to know certain pieces of information anyways in order for the story to make any sense. Okay. Oh, I can't wait for fire to get stronger. I imagine like the range will get a lot better. I love the FPS damage, man. Like boom, 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 boom. Sora seems like a character who thinks that I don't know why I'm here, all I know is I must follow the plot. Well, he was designed to be a plot device. That's very true. He is designed exclusively to be a plot device and nothing else. Do you think Final Fantasy and Disney mixes well? Do I think they mix well? I mean, can they work together? Sure, I think they can work together. And they pulled off something that, yes, a lot of people are engaging with. And Kingdom Hearts has a very big fan base, so yeah, I think they mix well in that sense. Are you asking, do I think they mix well? Like, can I imagine like Final Fantasy 16 being like Kingdom Hearts Final Fantasy 16? No, it's just a different style that they're going for. And then Kingdom Hearts has its own style that's going for. The styles themselves aren't necessarily compatible, but the styles of Final Fantasy games in the past and Kingdom Hearts games is compatible enough. Yeah, I would say so. I like long exposition if it's done well enough, like FF12 had that, but wasn't as good as it could have been. Exposition, there's a kind of dialogue that people call on-the-nose dialogue, which is where they just dump the information on you. Like all of a sudden, out of nowhere, completely inorganically, they just say, well, as you know, then they unload five paragraphs of exposition on you. That's not essentially the problem. That's more of the symptom of a problem. The symptom of the problem is that it's just dumping all this information on you. But the problem itself is that it's not motivated. So in real life, you notice that we actually talk in exposition, right? I'm just giving you facts. Here's A, B, C, and D. But it's motivated. In real life, people talk only when they feel they have the need to talk. And so when it's exposition dumping and it's on the nose, that just means that the scene or the conflict was not constructed correctly in a way that you want to know the information in a clear and engaging way. All right, we're alone. I'm all alone. There's no one to deride me. But you gotta have friends. Stop singing. It's no wonder you have no friends. Okay, everything's good. Let's do this. What the? Oh, my God. Oh my God. Ah, context menu, awesome. Nice, okay, the context menu. You gotta exploit the context menu. That hurt. Oh no. No. What happened? It was a mini game.
You have my trust.
How do you not know, man? I mean, Captain. Even with a faking the deeper voice, it's pretty damn clear that it's a woman's voice.
So, Ping.
So these stories are interesting. It's just that there's nothing at stake for Sora. He's just kind of standing on the side and watching, but it's really Mulan's story that we care about, not Sora's. See, at least with Roxas, there was the whole dynamic between him and Haner. Two guys going through puberty and shit. Not quite. Oh, no. Oh, no. You mother... Get some red rocket, motherfucker! Oh, bitch! What's up now? What? I'm confused. What happened? Yeah. Glad to be a lesson to you. There's no reason why the game shouldn't have a button mapping. Like push square to attack. Push, you know, X as a special attack or something, as opposed to using command-based actions.
And why should I believe you this time?
Well, I'm not sure if it's a Nier Automata style, but definitely not this style. This style is so clunky in so many different ways. It's almost like it's command-based as far as the menuing, but it's action-based as far as the gameplay. So those two styles don't mesh quite well together. Because in the heat of battle, what are you gonna do? You're gonna grow another thumb? And because the command menu requires that I push the D-pad, but moving requires I use the analog stick. So I can't use both of those at the same time. I can't move and cycle through commands at the same time. Buffering my actions during attacks, that's a workaround though. That's not a solution. In action games, you need like a way to quickly perform an action without having too many things get in the way of that. The more things there are in the way of jumping, or in the way of using a magic ability, or in the way of using a limit ability or an item, the worse off it is, because now you're not fighting the enemy necessarily, you're fighting the controls. There's no way I can cycle through my items and at the same time move. Because if I cycle through my items, I have to just stand there while the enemy is spam attacking me from every direction. Is what I'm saying. And that was very, very apparent in the first Kingdom Hearts game. In games, like action games where like reflexes really matter, you can't be like fumbling through a command list. You can disagree, but dude, look at almost every well-designed action game. Bayonetta, Devil May Cry 5. If those were command-based games, that would suck. Like, that would absolutely suck. Oh god, oh god. Hey, man, let me go. See what I'm doing? Like, I have to fumble through the menu while I'm, like, dealing with this bitch. Got the gap closer. I did. Okay. Oh, he's using his bird. That's why. Ooh, this is cool. Damn. Oh, okay. Oh no. I'm out of potions. No healing either. Come on. Oh, okay. I see it. You gotta block. I really appreciate that. That they've added more elements of progging, you know? Like, at first you don't really get what you're supposed to do. Like, it feels like, oh my god, why is it that I can't stun this bastard? And then once you finally figure it out, then, oh, that's what I'm supposed to do. Okay, then you just have to execute it. Great. You see some really skilled... No. See, here's what you're doing. You're taking an inherently flawed combat design mechanic, and it's like saying, oh, look at all these people that can build houses with broken hammers. So, yes, it's impressive that they can do that, but that's different from saying... you should be building a house with a broken hammer because someone else managed to find a workaround. Dude, just build it with a freaking correct-looking hammer. But it was, no, Devil May Cry 5 and Bayonetta, they had clunky problems, that's true, but that wasn't because of an inherent design issue. It's just that certain mechanics, like, I don't think, like, the form changes were necessarily, like, for Dante, were all that smooth. And the whole gameplay with V wasn't, it was more gimmicky than it was actually challenging. You have done for but that China. Wasn't like, this is like an inherently, fundamentally, Mulan. Like it's two yes. combat design philosophies that done. Don't mesh. Goofy. Yes, sir. Like the command thing is like, I have to cycle through menus of items captain. While I'm getting hit by six enemies at the same time. That's like saying, oh, a game doesn't have the ability to save, or you can't change your direction of jump mid-air, or when I push jump, it doesn't always jump. And then there do manage to be some people that beat the game that way, and like saying, oh, look at that. They suffered through crappy mechanics, therefore, that's the way that you should be playing it. No, janky mechanics do not make a challenge. That's why it's a meme. Like, that was one of the biggest issues I had with Resident Evil 3 Remake, is that they constantly shoved the camera right into Jill's shoulder. And then you can make the argument, well, oh, okay, well, that just makes it more challenging. No, I just can't see the bastard. I mean, the camera's jammed right into my shoulder that I can't see anything, and then when I get hit, it's like it's artificial. Just bam. And the FOV slider issue with Resident Evil Village, too. And that was the biggest issue I had with the first Kingdom Hearts game that they've significantly improved on. Whoa. Like the responsiveness of the controls, the responsiveness of the blocking, to a degree. Like the moment I could map a button onto an item was way better. Was awesome. Resource MP relative to the... If I take damage, though. They've improved on this, too. I mean, it looks a lot cooler. And plays a bit smoother. The only thing, though, is that the bullets are harder to... What the hell? Alright, this is getting kind of crazy. Shit's getting nutty! Oh, okay. Yeah, the back... Oh, God! What the hell? Oh, jeez. Well, that's flashy as hell. Didn't do much damage, though. I hope that I can get through this without having to do too much customization to the gummy ship. The Beast Castle? Really? Wasn't that the Hollow Bastion? I know y'all want some personal time with me, sorta, but just one at a time. Oh, can't wait for that fire to get bigger. Get out of here. Do you realize what you could have done? Alright, so this is the official Beast Castle. It wasn't the Hollow Bastion, like I thought, in the first game. They gave you a shop. This is cool, too. They gave you a shop everywhere you go. Oh, I got a contextual menu. I'll always take advantage of those. Nice. At times, it's just kind of cool, flashy shit. Push the contextual button, and then a bunch of crazy shit happens, and you win. The hell are you? Dude? Am I gonna have to do some QTEs to backflip away from these armaduras? Back off! Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay, I can't get that thing. I can go through here, right? The east wing. This is where you trapped Belle. Wait. Belle's trapped inside the room? Hold on, I thought...
I'm so happy you're here.
I thought Belle was already a princess during the first Kingdom Hearts game. In Kingdom Hearts 1, wasn't Belle already a princess and Beas was trying to save her because she was already his wife or something? And then now, everything's gone like back to the beginning. He's been acting strange lately. Oh, no. Oh, no. The only ones who might know why are locked up in the dungeon. The Undercroft from the West Hall. The dungeon is down there. The West Hall. Okay, past the Armadura things, right? Oh, fat dude! Fat dude! Okay. Yeah, I remember you. The two suits of armor that have huge gaps between them, but for some reason I can't conveniently get through. Yeah, it is a fetch quest. You're solving someone else's problems. You couldn't do that before? Seriously? Do you mind? I touched her in an inappropriate spot. I could just burn you, you know. Oh, I see. Then you gotta walk out of the way because she wakes up and she whacks you. Okay. Yeah, lots of little mini games. Oh no. It's a one-off mini game. Just like with the morale gauge in Mulan Land. Oh. You just had to, didn't you? You just had to. And here it goes. Oh, what? Okay. Just don't get greedy. I see that. I'll get greedy with this, but I can go up here. Oh, you can't get me up here, can you? Oh, it kind of sucks, though. You can't use your drive unless you're at level 3 first. Oh, baby. Oh, what the? What? I'm Dark Sora. How'd that happen? Oh, shit. I'm a savage little beast. Oh, no. Oh, no. I used my high potion, but it didn't. What? Wait, what am I doing? Wait, I'm missing something here. I'm clearly missing something here. Hold on, what the hell's going on? Fill the drive gauge and use healing light. Okay. Oh my god, will you die? All right. So they added a couple of little niceties and nuances to the mechanics that improved the experience. Oh, just for certain fights though. So was it entirely possible for me to beat that as Sora alone without Mickey at all? Okay, did we get anything new? Oh god damn it, I need that. Knocks a target into the air during a combo. Yes. Donald's the more interesting of this entire crew because of how childish he is. How childishly destructive he is.
An old beggar woman came to the castle and asked for shelter.
Oh! Oh, that's interesting. They're actually elaborating on the woman at the beginning of Beauty and the Beast. The enchantress that dressed herself up as a witch and then sought shelter. And yeah, like the beast turned her away and then she saw that he had no love in his heart and turned him into a beast. That was never touched upon in the original story. She was just a random woman. A random witch that cursed the beast. But now they're actually giving her... Oh, like an appearance in the game? That's pretty cool. So like I said, it's lore. Very lore heavy. That's where the appeal of the game is. At least this part. You know something's probably wrong when the most interesting character isn't the main character. The second half of Kingdom Hearts 1 probably wouldn't have happened if it weren't for Donald. That is true. Donald was the one character that showed the most character, really. Yeah, like him laughing at Tinkerbell and ha 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 kind of thing. That was what kept the party lively. That was what gave it charm. Where Sora is just, I have my friends to protect me. My friends are my power. Trust in yourself, and you can achieve anything. Right. Cool, I'm getting stronger and stronger. And the save points are very generous. The save points are very conveniently placed along checkpoints in the story. There's a second floor, but the second floor is like only up until... It only reaches up till here. So, architecturally, this makes no sense. This door should go into the middle of nowhere. Approach each lantern, use the reaction command sprinkle to put it out. Okay. Is it timed, though, is the thing. Oh, no, it's timed. Yeah. Another minigame. I mean, I appreciate the minigames have been more incorporated into the regular stages. Before, in the first Kingdom Hearts game, the minigames were relegated to very specific parts of the game. Like in the 100 Acre Woods, mostly. Oh no, I gotta wait for everyone? You know, I could just carry her and make it faster. A lot of the dialogue is just very basic. How are you doing? I'm doing fine. Push that block. That block over there? I see it. Do you see it? Okay, push the block. Oh, wait, the combo. Oh, nice. I can lift him into the air. There we go.
I've had enough of strength. There's only one thing I want.
What?
To love.
Be loved in
return. Be loved in return. To have a heart.
Who could ever love a beast?
Ooh, touched a nerve. Probably not a good time to tell you that me and Belle are dating, is it? Oh no, I gotta beat him.
Hey, Prince.
Oh no. Cogsworth power. Yeah. What the fuck? Okay. It's a gimmick fight. Yeah, I gotta do that shit. Knock him out. Okay, and we gotta do this thing, right? This thing? Oh, yeah, it wasn't a hard fight, but it was very fun. It's very clever.
No excuses.
All the Disney characters so far have been so colorful. They've been so colorful. They've had so much character. Minus Sora. I'll take the Beast, and I'll take Goofy. Thank you. Yeah, so far, I love the Disney characters, how they're done here so far. Kind of unfortunate that Sora doesn't follow the same example. He's sleeping in a busted up bed and shit. It very cleverly uses the Disney world, incorporating it into the gameplay. And I'm looking forward to getting more maneuverability, number one, and also expanding upon my skill set in terms of range. Like this fire spell, I can't wait to get an expanded version of that. Oh god! Oh god, what the fuck? What? I don't know what happened, but it was damn cool. Oh, fat boy. What the hell? Okay. That reversal is so useful for so many different reasons that I kind of wish that I can use him at any time. What the hell? Yeah, like that. Why doesn't she just do what she's told? Damn. Tempa. Her spirit is what makes Belle so special. We gotta go find her. I need Sora to be like that. Just... Why doesn't Kairi just do what she's told? I need cure. That's the other thing too. So I don't have to waste so many potions. I need cure. So here we be. So we can now use this castle as farming, grinding, if we need to. However, I am told that even in Proud Mode, you don't need to grind. All right. So what's your gimmick? Mickey support? Okay. Where are you? Uh-huh, what? Oh, you're the chandelier! Oh, interesting. I'm fighting the chandelier. That's very clever. Very clever. Chance? Oh, it becomes part of the environment. Oh, no. Ah, ha, ha, ha. I see ya. You know, the fights here aren't hard, but they're very fun. They're like fat chocobo fun. I love seeing the way that they use the concept of that specific Disney world. Chandelier Ifrit? What the hell are you? So run around. You're invisible! Oh, shoot! That's very, very clever. Can I blast you? You hate ice, right? Freeze! Okay. What phase? Oh no, at the beginning? That's why this phase wasn't so hard. So don't waste the form on this dude. No! Oh, no. Right here. Stand right here. No, not the windows. Stand away from the windows. between the windows. I have no choice. Second form, there's one series of attacks that just goes all out ham. It's like a 5-hit combo. I lost it. My form. No, this shit. I hate that. Okay, watch out for the combo. Watch out for the combo. Well, not much of a way to block. What is that? It's a spam attack. What the? That's some cheap bullshit, dude. He hits you once and then it spam attacks you with 5 hits. That doesn't matter. The first phase, I can't. Oh, okay. Come on. What am I doing? Drive up to level 3. Come on. Almost got you, bitch. There we go. That was just lucky. It's almost like in the Valor form, you can somewhat just kind of cheese it, like brute force your way through it, because you hit them from so many different directions with so many different attacks.
When a strong-hearted person turns into a heartless, a nobody is created too.
See,
the organization, they've got control of all the nobodies.
That's right. They were gonna make you into a heartless.
So if the beast became a heartless, then a nobody also forms from the beast. I have limited high potions. I also don't have dodge, and I don't have cure either. Okay, there we go. Oh, what the? It costs everything? Now I understand why they gave you that MP recharge. If cure uses up all your MP, then it uses all your MP regardless if you have full MP or just a fraction of your MP left. You might want to remove that MP recharge for certain spells if you want to leave a little bit for cure. But is the potency of cure dependent on how much MP you have left? So if I have only 10 MP left versus 100 MP left, is the cure potency the same? Hold on, so if I do cure? Oh, shoot. It's like this game is a... not like a rethinking of the first Kingdom Hearts game. It's much more like a repolishing, a deep, deep repolishing of the first Kingdom Hearts game. So combat is off the charts way better than the first. It doesn't solve a lot of the problems, as I said. It's not an evolution. It's not a revolution. It's more like an evolution. It gives you a lot of very convenient mechanics to bypass all the clunky stuff. So yeah, like instead of loading yourself up with a bunch of ethers and mega ethers and such, you just have one ether. So the ether will restore everything. But on top of that, you can sort of play the game in a way that you don't have to use ethers at all. You can just use all of your MP and it auto regenerates, of course, at a cost. You have to wait for it to restore. And then Sora seems like he has more combos too. He has the ability to a gap closer. He also has a launcher attack that allows him to knock enemies into the air. And now he also has a quick mid-air recovery and a quick mid-air counter. And then you also have the gauge forms, which you can use, you can time and like kind of store up in the middle of battle and then use it at the right moment. And also Mickey, who is a desperation move that happens sort of like the way that Odin or Gilgamesh happened in Final Fantasy games. So I guess the big thing for this game, its combat, is that it gives you more control. Seems like it gives you far more control of the combat, which was severely missing in the first game. You can only sort of play it in one way, right? You're using fire. Well, fire and ice were more or less kind of the same thing, except different elementals. Here, fire is an AoE ability, which I imagine is going to get bigger and stronger. The ice is your launcher ability. And then cure, instead of using Kira and Kiraga, they designed it so that it works around the MP recharge system. So now you have to make choices, which is great. So the game is giving you more control, but also more choices. You can play the game in a variety of different ways as you choose. So if there's a way to actually get out of the stun lock animation that happens in the middle of combos, that'd be great too. There sort of is, right? In the Valor form, in your gauge form, you can break out of combos early. Right now, the gauge form allows me to cheese through certain fights, but just because I was lacking certain abilities that made it harder to, like, a dodge with iframes. And that was also why I loved the reversal, because it gave you iframes as well. Some kind of dodge that gives me iframes I can time. So the more action gamey it makes it, the better. The more it gets away from the command-based clunkiness. The problem with Kingdom Hearts, the first Kingdom Hearts, where I felt like, well, the abilities themselves didn't really resolve the issue with the clunkiness in the combat, was because, yes, you got some of the better abilities later on, but here, you're getting like a fundamental taste of what the abilities are at their heart. Like, oh, the fire does a fire AoE spell around you, and the ice spell does a ranged attack in front of you. Okay, you get that. You get a sense of how the combat's going to work, and then later on, the abilities just add on top of that. So, if the fire spell was helpful before as a DPS attack to kind of get enemies like off you, then it'll become even more of that later down the line. So, it feels like there's a progression system in the combat, as opposed to it withholds all the good stuff from you up front, and so you're just going through the first 20 hours of the game like, what the hell, man? Why is this combat such a piece of shit? And then later, it alleviates the combat. Doesn't improve it, but it alleviates the combat by giving you an ability that you wonder, no, shouldn't I have gotten this early on? That kind of thing. So it's less of that, which is why I guess the combat feels so much better. There's actually less choices as far as I'm noticing the equipment. This game seems to prioritize its combat far more on abilities, less on levels and less on equipment, which is great. Because in the first Kingdom Hearts game, I remember you got like a new Keyblade after almost every single boss fight. Right, and you got way more equipment in the game early on, like all the Proterra chains and Thunder chains and such. They added stuff like there's a Moogle at every area, so you don't have to go back to Traverse Town to access the shop. Stuff like that, and more save points that are more along the lines of the story. This game is far more story cutscene guided too. The Disney worlds are better than the first Kingdom Hearts game in that the characters are better. The worlds themselves are not better. In fact, I think that the set design and the level design of this game is a regression. Like the Beast Castle was the main hall, one room to the right that doesn't really lead anywhere, a hallway to the upper right that leads to Belle's room, and that's it. A hallway to the left that is like basically three or four rooms or five rooms, and then the main room right in front of you, that's it. The first one, I could have sworn that the areas were bigger, and the characters feel more fleshed out. The Disney characters feel more fleshed out, like way more. And that unfortunately has the side effect of Sora being quite boring. Like, it's almost like everything in the first Kingdom Hearts game is enhanced here. If the Disney characters before were like, oh, okay, here, it's interesting, it's clever in the way that it uses its puzzles and the way that it uses the world, well, here it's more interesting. But Sora, in the first game, he was quite boring. Well, here he's like really boring. You don't need to play the first Kingdom Hearts game to enjoy this one. The only context you got in the first Kingdom Hearts game that was even relevant was all the stuff with Sora, Kairi, Riku, which were quite sparse to begin with, and the Heartless. That's it. And even the Heartless, you don't even need story context to understand them. In the first game, you could have given it to me in a bit of lore here, and that's it. By the end of Kingdom Hearts 2, if it's following the same formula as the first Kingdom Hearts game, then I have more or less an idea what to expect. In the first Kingdom Hearts game, the way it's structured is that the first part of it, like sort of the tutorial, is like the Kingdom Hearts stuff. It's Sora, it's Kairi, it's Riku, it's everything related to that island. And then towards the end was where we got a resolution of that. But all the stuff in the middle was just Disney stuff. Here's Aladdin world, here's the Mermaid world, here's Nightmare Before Christmas world. You know, like a bunch of siloed worlds. And Sora is just kind of being taken along for the ride. I imagine it's going to be the same structure here. You got basically the Roxas section, which was the tutorial section, which was a more interesting section. And then we're going to get a bunch of siloed Disney worlds, and Sora is just there for the ride. But then towards the end is where you're going to get more of Roxas and the resolution of that very beginning. Clearly, I can see now that all the Disney stuff is being put front and center, and everything else sort of be damned. Like, Disney clearly made this game with the purpose of pushing forward their brand and their IP. So this game is like a marketing vehicle for Disney, and that's the first and foremost the priority. As you can tell from the way that the game is structured. And then everything else takes a backseat. That's not a bad thing, but what that does mean is that inevitably, unfortunately, Sora, his character, and his story beats, they suffer as a result. And that's probably why the section with Roxas was so good, or by comparison, because the moment you got control of Sora, it defaults to the game being a advertising vehicle for Disney, as opposed to a game that's just trying to tell some semblance of an interesting story on its own terms.